Hello everybody, my name is Cube6 and today we're going to be taking a look at two really cool shopfront or store designs that you can build in your Minecraft survival world. So yeah, let's go ahead and take a look at each design. Now this was a user requested video, so if you guys have any Minecraft redstone contraptions that you want me to try to take on, then just put that down in the comments below and your comment might be the next video. So yeah, that would be greatly appreciated. Since this video will be a little bit longer, I added timestamps down in the description to jump right to the tutorial. So if you guys want to go down there, I have some timestamps, so make your life a lot easier. Let's go ahead and take a look at the two designs. Now the first design, as you can see, it's pretty small, you'll see the redstone a little bit. But it's a shame because this one is the simplest one, but it also doesn't have a lot of functionality. So it has like zero customizations. So, you can customize what payment option and what is the product, but you can't customize how many you're selling and what is the final amount that you've given with one payment. Hopefully that made sense. Let's just go ahead and test it out. So if I wanted some dirt and I just happen to have a spare diamond on me, I can go ahead and open this chest and go ahead and drag my diamond into the chest. As you can see, it instantly disappears. Some redstone stuff will happen down below. And if I look inside of this chest, as you can see, some dirt is filling in this chest quite quickly. And it will fill all the way up to 2 stacks. This one is, again, like I said, it was rigid, so you cannot change the amount that you're given. So as you can see, it stops right at 2 stacks. I can go ahead and take my dirt and just walk over to the next shop. Now this shop is, as you can see, it's a lot more complicated, but the way I designed it is so that it will all be underneath the ground, so you can only see the chest and the inputs. So this one is a lot more complicated, but you have a lot more options to actually customize. You can actually customize what payment you are actually going to pay with, and how much of the product that is going to be exported to the export chest, and how many buttons or how many items you are actually selling. So there's a lot of things that you can customize with this design, and so let's go ahead and take a look at how this thing actually works. So if I go into the payment chest here, open that chest, go ahead and drop my diamond in there. As you can see, it instantly folds away. Now this light will pop on, indicating that you can actually now select what item that you want to be buying. So in this case, I'm kind of feeling like a slime ball type of guy. I'm gonna go ahead and click this button. As you can see, this light now disappears, so I can not actually select any other items. And as you can hear, the droppers will be dispensing the items really loud. I could not make it silent, but it is dispensing exactly 16 items. I have it set to 16 items, and again, you can actually change this number to whatever you want. So a stack, 2 stacks, 3 stacks, it's really up to you. So I can go ahead and take my slime balls and walk away, but I actually have 2 diamonds to left, so I can actually go ahead and put 1 more diamond in there. The light will turn on, allowing me to choose what I want. So I'm gonna go ahead and choose some gold, and when that dispenser stops, I can actually look inside the chest and I will have 16 gold at my disposal, so I can go ahead and take that and walk away. Alright, so those are the two storefront designs that we will be showcasing in today's video. So yeah, let's go ahead and take a look at the redstone for each design. So here is all of the redstone for each design. Now I think you can probably tell which one is which. Starting with the simpler design, this, you know, you're probably thinking, this isn't simple, this is like extremely complicated. Well, you have to take an account of all the things that actually have to happen in order to actually deliver these items, and the correct amount of items for that matter. So we actually, if you input the wrong payment, it actually gets filtered out and gets brought to the right, the wrong chest. And if you actually add the payment in, then it would actually get filtered out into the right chest, allowing the whole entire system to actually activate. So that is an item filter right here. And then we need a T flip-flop in order for the clock to continue going to power this dispenser elevator to actually jut the items into the top chest here. And then we also needed a comparator to tell when the two stack limit is up, and we'll actually push down this piston, allowing everything to turn off and this T flip-flop to go back into the correct position, and everything will turn off. So there's a lot of stuff going on. It's not that simple. I wish it was that simple, but it sadly is not that simple. So yeah, that is the simple design. So let's go ahead and take a look at the complex design. Now this complex design is, look at this, it's huge. But it has a lot of customizable options for you guys to play around with. So you can, you know, extend the button array as long as you want. You can customize what type of payment that you are going to be paying with, and you can also customize how many items are going to be exported to the export chest by changing a hopper to. So yeah, this is an extremely cool design, but I can totally understand why people don't want to build this, because it's just, look at how many hoppers that is, and look how many pistons and repeaters and stuff. So yeah, it's kind of not survival friendly, but I think it is doable, and it is actually super cool. So yeah, let's go ahead and take a look at how to build the simpler design before we actually do the complex design. Alright, so let's go ahead and build the very first design. So let's go ahead and get things started with a pillar that is 5 blocks tall, or if you want this to be in the ground, then you would have to dig down 5 blocks, and the 5th block will be your floor level. So this is where your chest will be on the 6th block, and then this will be the export chest, so we need the import chest just 1 block away from the export chest, just like that. And now come to the leftmost chest and go all the way down to the bottom and build up 2 blocks. And now the remaining sets of blocks are going to be 3 hoppers going down into one another, just like that. Now you can go ahead and destroy one of these support blocks and come around towards the back and place a chest here and a chest here. Now this chest right here will be your declined items, so all of the items that are not the key. And this item right, or this chest right here, will be all of the items that are the keys, like the diamonds and stuff like that. Now you can go ahead and destroy this support block and this destroy this hopper right here, because we need this hopper to be facing into another hopper. Place this hopper here, and then place that hopper facing into that other hopper, just like that. And so now you should have a setup like this, and now we can go ahead and begin the logic for this whole entire circuit. So we can go ahead and start things off by this third hopper right here, by placing a block right there, and have a redstone comparator coming out of that second hopper, just like this. This redstone comparator go right into a block, and then 2 blocks down, just like this, to create this kind of backward C shape. Now we can go ahead and add a redstone torch right here, and a redstone dust here, and then a redstone repeater set to 3 ticks, just like that. Now come over to the other side and add a block on this extruding hopper, just like this, and then kind of create this V shape, just like this. And now in this little crevice right here, we're going to add another comparator. And then now we can actually add another V shape, so just like this. And then we are actually going to add a little wing on the left side of the V, just like this. Now add 2 pieces of redstone dust here and here, and then add 1 redstone torch right here, and that would be the whole entire item sorter completely finished. So the very last step to do is just go into this extruding hopper and go ahead and place your key and 18 or 21 items of completely renamed to something completely random. And again, I'm not creative, so that's, you know, that's the best name that I could come up with. All right, so let's go ahead and move on to the orange circuit. Alright, so come directly underneath this V, this last V that you made, and place a block right here, an adjacent block right next to that block, just like this. Now in this little crevice, we're going to place a repeater going right into this block, and that repeater will power this dropper, which that dropper will be facing right into a hopper, just like that. Now what we're going to do is we're going to go inside the dropper and place any item. It doesn't really matter, it doesn't have to be renamed, it can just be any item. Now come over to the side right here and place a block right here with a comparator going into a sticky piston facing upward. Now I know a sticky piston, that's a shame, but there's things called swamps, so yeah. go ahead and place an observer, red side facing towards the back of the contraption, and then have another observer right here facing in the opposite direction, just like this. So the red is facing towards the front of the contraption. Now this observer will go right into a block right here, and then add another block right off to the side. This observer will be powering this redstone dust, which will be powering this repeater with no ticks. Now this repeater will go right into a dropper line, so we're going to go ahead and add three droppers right the way up into this top chest, just like this. Now what we're going to do is we are going to do the detection system for this top chest. So go ahead and grab a smooth stone slab or whatever slab that you have available. And go ahead and place that slab right here. And this will be the only exposed bit on the top of the surface. So just have a slab and then a comparator. And that comparator will go right into a block. And then have two more blocks right here and here, just like that. Now, when you're placing the floor, you will have to have a slab right here because there's going to be two pieces of redstone dust, and if you have a full block, they will be cut off, so make sure you have a slab on that area. Now go ahead and come down through this central area right here and place a sticky piston facing downwards with a block on its face. Now you can go ahead and destroy this block right here and grab yourself a redstone torch and place that redstone torch in this crevice like here. Go ahead and place a piece of redstone dust here and a repeater right here going right into a block, and then there will be a piece of redstone here and then another block right here. So if we come around to the back side here, we can go ahead and place a torch right here that will lock this hopper, and everything will be completely done. The very last step to completing this circuit is we are going to have to grab the input chest or the product chest that you will be feeding into this dropper line. So just place this hopper right here and add a double chest right on top of that hopper, just like that. And that should be the whole entire circuit completely finished. So if you can go ahead and give it a tester. Before you give it a tester though, you actually have to input some blocks down in the last dropper right here. And that should be working just fine. So go ahead and place a diamond right in the top or your payment. As you can see, everything will start kicking into action. Some orange will be flowing up, or your product will be flowing up into your chest, and everything will be working completely fine. Alright, as you can see, it will stop right when that two stacks will be available, and you can just go ahead and take that out of the chest and walk away. And so yeah, so that is the simple design. So let's go ahead and take a look at the more complex design, but personally it's my favorite design. Alright, so now we're going to go ahead and be building the complex version, so let's go ahead and jump right into it. So first things first, we're going to kind of start the same way as we did the first tutorial. So pretty much we're going to go ahead and build up five blocks, or in your case you want it to be underneath the ground, so you're going to go ahead and dig down five blocks, and the fifth block will be your floor block, and your sixth block will be your chest block. So you can go ahead and destroy those blocks. And now we're going to go ahead and add the other chest one block away from this chest. You can go ahead and destroy those support blocks. So right now you have two chests just floating right on top of your land right here. Now what you're going to do is you're going to go to the leftmost chest and go all the way to the very bottom, place two support blocks just like this, and now the remaining blocks with hoppers going all the way down and into one another, just like this. Now go ahead and destroy one support block right here and place a chest here and a chest here. And now you can go ahead and destroy that support block and destroy this hopper as well. Place one hopper going right into this jutting out chest, and then place another hopper going into that hopper, just like that. So now we can go ahead and begin the logic for all of this circuits. So now let's go ahead and come down to the third hopper right here and go ahead and place a block. And now coming out of the second hopper, we're going to place a comparator. This comparator will go right into a block with a redstone torch on it. Now directly underneath this redstone torch, we're going to place two blocks just like this. And one of those blocks will have a redstone dust on them, and the other one will have a repeater set to three ticks, just like that. Now what we're going to do is we're going to come to this hopper right here, place a block, and we're going to try to make this little V shape right here, and then a comparator in this little crevice right here. Now this is where it starts to differ from the first design, so we have to go ahead and place another V shape just like this, but instead of doing that little wing, we're going to actually hold off on this block, and what we're going to do is we're going to add two pieces of redstone right here. Instead of adding the redstone torch right here, we're actually going to go ahead and add the redstone torch right here. So we added the redstone torch here, have a block And then this is where it gets a little different. We're actually going to add a slab right here with a piece of redstone dust on that slab. Now this piece of redstone dust will go right into a block to lock this hopper. Alright, so now we can go ahead and go into this hopper and place one of your payments and 21 blocks, any block, renamed to whatever you want. So pretty much rename it to anything you want, and it has to be 21 blocks, and then your payment right in the first slot. All right, so I'm gonna, later in the tutorial, I'll show you how to customize this as well. All right, so the orange circuit is much more simpler than the first actual tutorial, so let's go ahead and take a look at it. So right underneath the V shape that you just made, we're gonna go ahead and place a block right here, and adjacent from that block, we're actually gonna place another block just like this. Now in this crevice, we are going to go ahead and place a repeater going into this block. Now this block is going to go ahead and power this dropper, and this dropper is going to feed right into this hopper, just like this. Now we are going to actually place a block right here, and a comparator facing right the way out of this hopper right here. This comparator will go right into a block, and this comparator will be powering this piece of redstone. This piece of redstone will be going into this block, which will power this repeater, which will go right into this block. Wow. That is a mouthful. Now what we're going to do is we're going to go into this dropper and place a single item. It doesn't matter, just any item. It doesn't have to be your name, it doesn't have to do anything. It just needs to be one singular item. So let's go ahead and do the yellow circuit. So now I do apologize for if I'm doing these circuits a little too fast. I am just trying to cut down on the time that this video takes to get completed. So yeah, let's go ahead and start things off with the redstone lamp. So go ahead and place a block on the export chest, and go ahead and place a lamp on the underside of this block right here. Now this lamp will tell you when you can go ahead and press those buttons, and now let's go ahead and place those buttons. So one block adjacent from that lamp, just like this. Now this will be the button array, so you can go ahead and add your buttons. And now this is pretty complicated, so if you want to have more buttons than this, all you have to do is just extend the button array and then just continue the same pattern that we're doing the yellow circuit and the purple circuit even after this. And I'll be explaining all of this in the near future. So all you have to do to complete this yellow circuit is come down to the bottom here and place three blocks right here. And again, if you have a fourth button or a fifth button, then you're going to go ahead and do the same steps that I'm doing right now, but just increasing it to how many buttons that you want to have. So now what we're going to do is we are going to add one more block line, just one block above those blocks that we just placed. And now this one is going to be the exception. So one, we only have to do this for this one line. Just go ahead and place a block here, and then a torch right here. So this will only have to be on this one line. So come down to the back side and place a line of repeaters. And again, if you have a fourth button, then you would add a fourth repeater, and so on and so forth. So go ahead and add a line of redstone dust, and those repeaters will go into three torches, and then there will be three more torches on these blocks right here. So now we can go ahead and put some sticky pistons facing downwards from the button array with blocks on their faces just like this. Now what we're going to do is place three blocks on these sides of these torches just like this. Kind of tricky, but once you get it, you should be good. And now we're going to be creating this donut type shape just like this. So now just kind of create this donut just like this. And what we're going to do is we are going to place three repeaters right here and three more repeaters right here. And again, I can't really stress this enough. If you have a fourth button, then you're going to do all of these steps, and including the purple step again. So now come down to the bottom or the donut hole and place three pieces of redstone dust. Alright, so come down here to the donut hole and place a block right here and another block right here. Now line those two blocks with redstone dust just like that, and now come over to the front side and place a redstone torch on this block right here. So let's go ahead and take a look at the final step, which is the droppers. So pretty much all you have to do is just place three droppers right here, and then three more hoppers right here going into those droppers just like that. Now inside each one of these droppers, we are going to go ahead and place one block. It doesn't have to be any block. It doesn't have to be like a special block. It doesn't have to be renamed. It's just any block is fine. All right, so let's go ahead and move on to the purple circuit. All right, to get things started with the purple circuit, all we are going to do is just come down to the bottom right here and add a line of blocks right here with redstone torches on those blocks just like this. Now, if you have a fourth button or a fifth button, then you want to extend it out to the corresponding amount of buttons that you have on the button array. So just something to keep in mind. Now come down to the backside of these redstone torches right here and place a line of repeaters and then a line of redstone dust just like this. Now these repeaters have to be set to 2 ticks just like this. And then to finish this part off, we are going to add 2 pieces of redstone dust, break this block here, add a sticky piston facing upward, add a block on that sticky piston, and then add a repeater going right into that sticky piston. We are going to leave this for now. This has to be connected to the gray circuit, so we are going to leave this for now. Come up to the top right here and place blocks on these sides of these torches. It's pretty tricky, but once you get the hang of it, you should be completely fine. Now, what you're going to go ahead and do now is place comparators on the blocks that you just placed, and those comparators will go right into a block, and then those blocks will have redstone torches on those blocks just like that. Now, what we're going to do is these be placing the storage chests for all of the items that you are selling, so we can go ahead and just place some double chests right here. And those will be right there. Now what we're gonna do is we actually have to go ahead and do the dropper line first. So come over to the orange circuit right here and place a dropper line facing upwards, 3 droppers facing upwards and into one another going right into this export chest. Now what we're gonna do is we're gonna come down to the bottom of this dropper right here and place a hopper and then extend the hopper line all the way around to 1 block off of these chests right here. So yeah, I know, how are you gonna get all this iron, bro? It's pretty ridiculous. So, but I do have faith in you. So yeah, that is a lot of iron. So now we can go ahead and continue with even more iron hoppers to meet up with these chests just like this. And now we can actually go underneath these chests right here and place hoppers going into this main central hopper line like that. Alright, so that has been the whole entire purple circuit done, so let's go ahead and take a look at the most important and last circuit, the gray circuit. Alright, to get things started, we are going to come over to this hopper right here, and this is going to be the detection hopper, so when items flow right here, it will get detected. So go ahead and place in a block adjacent from that hopper just like this. Now add a comparator coming right the way out of that hopper, and then we are going to place another block, and that comparator is going right into this repeater. Now we're going to go ahead and place 6 blocks just like this, and then we're going to create this sort of shape on the end. We're going to go ahead and place a block down like this, and then a block up just like this. Now what we can do is we can line this with redstone components. So go ahead and place 2 pieces of redstone dust here and here, and place 2 more pieces of redstone dust here and here. Now place 1 comparator facing in this direction and turn around and place another comparator facing in the opposite direction to create this sort of pulse extender right here. Now come down in this little crevice right here and place a repeater going right into this block. Now what we're going to do, place a sticky piston facing upwards from this block just like this. Now this sticky piston will have an observer, the red side facing towards these comparators, and then we are also going to place another observer on this hopper line just like this, so the red side facing towards these droppers just like this. Now what we're going to do is we're going to place slabs all the way along until it reaches this dropper line right here. Then go ahead and place a repeater right here and then redstone on all of those slabs just like that. Now as you can see, these are actually interfering, so we can go ahead and add a block to block those off just like that. Now let's go ahead and take a look at probably the most important part of the gray wool circuit, which is the timer. Alright, come down to this yellow line right here and go ahead and add a piece of redstone right here and a repeater. It is very important this repeater has no ticks on it, or else the amount of items will differ if you add more delay to this repeater. So after this repeater, we're going to go ahead and add 4 pieces of redstone dust, so 3 right here and then 1 piece right here. This redstone dust will go right into a block, and then we'll have 2 more blocks up right here and here. Now you can go ahead and line all of those with redstone as well. Now we are going to go ahead and be making a T flip-flop. So if you guys do not know how to make a T flip-flop or just want an in-depth tutorial on how to make one, then click the card in the top right now, and that will take you to a tutorial to build a silent one or a loud one. It's really up to you. And also, the link will be in the description, so if you are on an iPhone, then you can go ahead and click that as well. So what we're going to do to finish off this T flip-flop is just to add two torches on the sides of these two blocks right here, then add one sticky piston facing in this direction right here, then add a redstone block right here, and then finalize it with another sticky piston facing in this direction there. Now what we're going to do is we are going to add two hoppers facing into one another, and I think this is called an etho clock. I'm not 100% sure, but don't quote me on it. So it's just a timer pretty much. So go ahead and come into this hopper with the redstone block right here and place 14 blocks in this item hopper just like that. Now 14 of any item, it doesn't have to be something special, it doesn't really have to be renamed, it just has to be 14 items. Now the reason why we have 14 items inside of this hopper is to actually allow 16 items from one of these product chests to get dispensed and actually go into this export chest right here. The amount of items that are in this hopper, you add 2 to that, and that's how many items will be in the export chest when you click that button. Alright, so come down to these two hoppers right here and place two redstone comparators facing out of those hoppers just like that. Now these comparators will go right into two blocks which have two redstone torches on those blocks just like this, and now those two redstone torches will have blocks on them just like that. Now what we're going to do is we're going to create a staircase to get up on top just like this, and now what we're going to do is we're going to add redstone dust all the way along here just like this. Now what we're going to do is we are going to come down to this redstone right here, and we are going to connect it to the purple circuit that I said that we were going to leave for the gray circuit. So now it is connected, and that, believe it or not, is actually the final step to the whole entire design. So now I'm just going to go ahead and run through all the customizations and things and how to actually make this thing actually function. Alright, so the very last step is to go ahead and stock your items. So there is a specific way in order to stock your items, so go ahead and go into the chest and dump all of your items in there. But you actually have to take one item out of your chest and actually place it inside this hopper below that chest, and that will have everything corresponding the first time you press it. So now we can go ahead and do the same exact thing for all of the melons. So just go ahead and go into this hopper and then put one of the desired items into that bottom hopper or the corresponding hopper underneath the chest. Alright, so you can customize the item array. So pretty much just add as many blocks and as many buttons as you want to the item array, and pretty much just you're going to go ahead and continue this, you know, shape all the way along this circuit. So pretty much, and even going into these purple circuits as well, you would need to do all of those purple circuits to increase the button array. Now to customize what item that you are actually accepting as payment, you can go ahead and go into this hopper and just swap out the item for whatever you want. But say if you want a diamond and an emerald to be accepted as payment, then all you have to do is just go ahead and put an emerald as one of these blocks right here, just like that. And say if you want an iron as well, you can swap one of those blocks as well, and you can swap another one, so you can have a maximum of 4 inputs for accepted payments. Now, like I said, in order to have the desired amount of output, we can go ahead and change this block in here. So pretty much the number of outputs that you have in that chest will be 2 subtracted from that number to get the items that you will put in this hopper here, or this hopper, depending on which one that you have items in. Alright, so that has been the whole entire design completely finished. So yeah, this has been a user requested video, so if you guys do have any Minecraft redstone contraption that you do not know how to build or just want me to take a look at it, then just put that down in the comments below and I will take a look at it and see if I can actually build it. So again, thank you so much for watching, and if you liked the video, then please make sure to leave a like, and make sure to subscribe, and yeah, thank you guys so much for watching. Again, my name has been MrCube6, and I'll see you guys in the next one, and goodbye.